All right, this is exciting. We're on the play, folks. We are on the play. So excited. So we don't have an artifact in our hand, so I'm going to lead out with the Gossip Monger turn one. This totally looks like a human. I guess you can't see his legs. And he's got kind of that thick dwarf beard, but like, this is kind of how everybody wear their beards these days anyways. So, just could just totally be just a normal dude. All the one drops. We even have protection against like getting blown out by Declaration in Stone because we can flip this one. Is our opponent on Blue-White Flash? Yep. Smuggling Copter. When I was first making proxies for the Pro Tour, I proxied, like I made a green-black, the Aggro Delirium deck. And I just proxied all the smugglers' copters as smuggling copters. Just accidentally, I just didn't know all the names of the cards. And it tilted Andrew Beckstrom to no end. It was great. Let me think. I'm assuming playing these two is just better this turn. I don't get to attack with the Exemplar, but then like my always watching next turn is just ridiculous. My opponent probably has to. Yeah, I just want. This is just so much pressure. And by so much pressure, I mean I get to attack for three this turn. But wait. I mean, yeah, next turn I can flip this one, or this turn I can flip this one. My opponent doesn't have Spellcaller mana. We play Always Watching it. It's probably just going to be game. Like, I can't. Well, you know what? No. If my opponent plays the one copy of Declaration in Stone here, it would still be pretty good. But if they don't have it, then they're probably just dead. Yeah. Attack with everything. And this is one of the main reasons to play this deck, is that all the aggressive decks are favored against blue-white, because blue-white is a little bit clunky. And this deck has way more one drops, so you can really just punish kind of the blue-white decks that just play one spell a turn. I'm doing this so I can F6. Come on. I didn't actually run into numbers. I just assumed it was lethal, but it wasn't. We're very unlucky. What you got for me? It looks like nothing because Modo's lagging. And everybody knows when Magic Online lags, it means that your opponents have conceded. If you didn't know that well. I had no follow-up to that, so don't ask me. Yeah, all right. This is just good deck building. When you have a card that is just obviously not a very good card, after sideboard, you can just board it out every single game. And it makes sideboarding really easy. Having a couple is not bad, just for the human synergies. Also, just the fact that you have a creature that can instantly tap flash creatures for your other creatures is, you know, not awful. It's not great, but it's not awful. Okay, no artifacts here again, but good curve. Got some removal, got some one drops. Thinking. My opponent's gonna play like a turn two copter. Yeah. Okay. Getting that off the board seems decent. Nice. All right, kind of want to land here. Or Thali's Lieutenant will also accept that. But yeah, drawing a land to play Always Watching so that I could attack with everything and flip is pretty nice. Okay. So this is a very clear spell queller if they pass. It could be Reflector Mage, actually. Yeah, Reflector Mage would also be very good. That is the one card that allows you to come back when you're behind. What do you bounce? Gossipmonger? Expedition Envoy? Toolcraft Exemplar, interesting. I guess I could very easily just be sandbagging. Well, I should use this Declaration in Stone, but the question is whether or not I should flip the Gossipmonger. Or just attack for three. I'm just going to attack for three. Because I don't know what my opponent's going to play next turn. So like my Gossipmonger might just die. Especially with an active Selfless Spirit. See how many Gideons my opponent chose to keep in. Yeah, it wouldn't be terrible here. We are three drop flooded. Not enough lands. Interesting. So... got to be mindful of a potential spell queller, but I mean, I do have the removal spells, so I'm just going to play this. Like, yeah, we're not ahead enough where we can just really play around spell queller too much. Like, just let my opponent do it, next turn kill it, and then go about our day. Selfless Spirit doesn't really protect against any of our removal, which is nice. Alright. The race is on. My opponent could also have Archangel Avacyn. This could just all be a disaster. Alright, anyways, I'm going for it. Land. Alright. So it's actually very, very interesting. I think to play around Avacyn, I should attack first. Alright, what do I want to do? So, a couple of different things. My opponent could have Spellcaller to try to block. I can Stasis Nair the Spellcaller to get back my Thalia's Lieutenant, or I can just play Thalia, which is very good in the matchup. I think I just want to play Thalia, actually. This helps me against like a lot of the other Flash creatures. Okay, well, sure. Ooh, I gotta make sure I stack these correctly. Alright. I mean, actually, if my opponent has Archangel Avacyn, we're just dead. Like. Okay, no Avacyn. We're so lucky. Oh god. Too many three drops! Okay, how are we not dying here? Okay. So first thing, I got a declaration in stone, these two. But then I still just died to the flyers. Okay. Yeah. Not good. Not good times. Damn you, Spellcaller! Got nothing. Just fast draws. Maybe I want a 19th land on the play with the extra three drops I boarded in. I'm gonna mulligan this, tap land too slow. So it's all one drops, but like not a lot of reach and no artifacts. Then these are kind of slow. I'm gonna actually mulligan and get punished. Yep. Woo! Just sick top decks. Pretty sure this hand would just lose to a draft deck. Oh, can't win. Thraven Inspector, also known as Moat. I guess a top deck Smuggler's Copter would give us a tiny bit of hope. Have any of you guys ever won in a mold of three? Also, Dredge doesn't count. Dredge does not count. Ugh. Yeah. These are far more valuable as potential 3-2s, so I don't think I want to double block the Thraven Inspector. You know, if these were human, this was a great draw. As they are not, it is an incredibly medium draw. Oh man, this is a very, very close game of Magic. We got this. Oop. Wow. Also, this deck very bad at blocking. Okay, I guess we stem the bleeding, if you will. All right. I've had enough. Thought well. All right, we got one more match to go. Hopefully, we can break even and beat people down with this deck.